Governor Northam says there is one group of Virginians being hit disproportionately by COVID-19, Latinos. Hispanics make up just 10% of the population, but new data shows that they actually account for 45% of coronavirus cases and 35% of hospitalizations statewide, a trend people we spoke with want to turn around.
In operating their small shop in Martinsville, Victor Rios and his family have masks, gloves, and are taking all the safety precautions they can.
Is the reason why, you know, this thing is still spread.
Rios says while phase one was quiet, during phase two, he's seen a lot of people social distance less. It's been extra challenging, he says, when many of their Hispanic cultural traditions revolve around togetherness.
Barbecues, cookouts, and Mother Days. In the graduation, you know, just have a lot of big community and, you know, be together all the time.
Rios has friends suffering through coronavirus, as does Chris Tilly Lubb, president of the Hispanic advocacy group Casa Latina. She says Casa volunteers have witnessed some painful situations during grocery delivery drop-offs.
Two single moms with their kids sharing a space. They were both just desperately ill.
Tilly Lubb says crowded living conditions are common and just one factor that puts Latinos in the Roanoke Valley at higher risk for COVID-19. She says there are several elements at play.
So many of the folks who are here are not eligible for unemployment or for stimulus checks. So if they have any opportunity to return to work, they're going to return to work.
She also says many people don't know where to get tested or treatment and believes the answer is for the Hispanic community to receive aid regardless of legal status. As for Rios, he sees one of the biggest barriers to public health as the language barrier.
You hear English, you don't understand anything. To have more information for a Latino community.
And the governor's press conference today did include Spanish speakers, and Northam says his office is working to protect Latino communities. They will translate documents into Spanish and share information through media, distribute PPE kits, and set up free testing in areas with large Latino populations or a large number of uninsured people. The Health Equity Working Group is also tracking data to connect with the communities at greatest risk. The Supreme Court rejected President Trump's effort to end legal protections for 650,000 young immigrants. For now, they will keep their temporary protected status in the DACA program. Angel Romero is a DACA recipient. He came to the United States when he was only 2 years old. Now he says he can breathe a little bit easier.
Even though this decision is important for us, I know that there's still so much work to do.
President Trump was unhappy with the ruling, tweeting it was highly political. The DACA program was created in 2012.